filming schedule.
Okay. Well, the first two seasons, well, not each season, the qualifiers, right? We film it over like a month process, right? So we don't film it all in one day. We film it over several days. But what we do is we wear the same clothes sometimes, especially in the earlier seasons, because they might want to do rearrange different acts. So that way it seems like, does it make sense? And at least I know this season it was even more interesting because in one episode we would be in like three different outfits. That's pre-taped for you. That's the only difference. So, but it was funny actually. You know, it's a problem when my dad was like, "You wore that suit for 6 weeks." Man. You know, and I'm like, "Well, my producer's like, guys, you gotta figure something out." You wear the same clothes. And then Jennifer said that she goes, "Well, people will be mad. Like, I need to be wearing something different every day."
Okay, ready?
What do you do when you're choreographing and you get a block? Like you get stuck on something or a section? Like what do you do to help get yourself out of that and kind of figure out what to do?
Part of what I do is change my environment. I change my environment, I change my state. You know, obviously I'm in my head. You know, because usually when you get a block, it's because you're overthinking and you're crazy in your head about it. So I tend to either go outside, or go for a run, I just do something that changes my environment, changes what I feel. But also, I saw this amazing TED Talk a while ago, how it talked about in the, before the Renaissance, artists, or sculptors, or anybody that was sort of in that creative realm, they always gave half the credit to something else. They called them like daemons, or geniuses, right? And so if something was great, they'd only give half the credit. But if something was bad, they went to half the credit. So that took the pressure off a little bit. And then after the Renaissance, people started calling people geniuses. And they're like, okay, I'm a genius. This is coming from me. And it took all this pressure, right? So it talks about this creativity thing about how when you sort of call upon something else, you know, it doesn't matter if you're religious or spiritual or nothing like that. It's just like something different, like a creative source. And I was like, I'm going to try that one day. So one day I was like, I'm going to block and I was like, all right, man, let's go. And I kind of just like played around with it. It was kind of just fun, and it kind of worked, honestly, because it takes the pressure off. Because for me, you know, people ask me like, oh my gosh, I love this routine you did. It's my favorite routine of all time. I'm like, really? I choreographed that in 5 minutes in the bathroom. And then there's like routines, and I like slave over them. This is all my whole being. Oh my gosh. Oh, the nuance. And they're like, oh, that's cool. So most of the time when things just kind of come out and flow is usually when you produce your best work, for sure. Yes.
What are your biggest challenges while touring?
Biggest challenges while touring? Probably just staying healthy. You know what I mean? Honestly, it's a marathon. It's an absolute marathon. But for me, what's so important is that each show I give is like 100%. I remember doing a show in England, and I was doing 8 shows a week, and I was losing my voice by like Wednesday, Thursday, because I hadn't really learned how to use it properly yet. So it was like 19 years old, and I remember the producer saying to me, "Derek, just like, you know, just kind of like go 60% during the week, so you can, you know, go full out the weekend, you know, with the bigger audiences and stuff." And I was like, man, like, once those door curtains go up, once the light goes up, like, I only know 100%. I wouldn't even know how to like, pull back. So the reason why I say that is because staying healthy by doing the show that you're going to see tonight, which is incredibly, like, challenging and demanding, it's important for me to be, like, a peak athlete. You know, ice baths every night, eating the right foods, listening to things to keep my mind in the right place. That's another thing too. Psychologically, you can get a little bit like, in certain places and not feeling like doing something, tired, fatigued, mentally, not just physically. So it's important that my mind is as physically fit, or mentally fit, as my body. If that makes sense. Mm-hmm. Just all around. every question at the same time. Go.